It's been officially announced that Dave Filoni is now executive creative director at Star Wars. So what does this mean? Let's get right into it. Well, what does the title really mean? He was executive producer, and this is an official announcement. So he has been technically the creative director for some time, but they've now just made that an official position. The executive creator position basically means he now controls the canon, more or less. That's basically what it means. It means in terms of the fictional universe, he decides what is canonical and what is not canonical. Or to put it another way, that he is in charge of the story group. The story group at Lucasfilm is essentially the group of writers, and they look at the scripts and determine whether something makes sense or does not make sense in the fictional universe of Star Wars. The head of the story group, Pablo Hidalgo, has been pretty involved in the more recent things from Rise of Skywalker to Solo to The Force Awakens. And I think you can safely say he's been a little polarizing around the fandom. Some people like him, some people do not like him intensely. But essentially, that's what this really translates into, is he will decide, at least for a long while, what more or less will count as canonical within the Star Wars universe and the tone and direction of, again, the fictional story. So obviously he has some real power in terms of firing and hiring people, but Kathleen Kennedy technically is still in charge of Lucasfilm, but now he is in charge of the fictional universe side, and this covers everything. This covers comics, this covers television, this covers film. So he is literally in charge of deciding or not deciding, should we keep this thing, should we not keep this thing, should we keep it as canonical, should we not keep it as canonical. So if you've been keeping up with some of the more polarizing politics of Star Wars, obviously the question on everyone's mind is, will he retcon the sequel trilogy, will he make the prequels more prominent, etc., etc. Now, Filoni himself comes from the animation side. He's worked with George Lucas, but he hasn't always followed Lucas's orders. So a lot of pro-Filoni people hope that he's just going to keep much more to what George wanted. But he's often been very public that what George wanted, for instance, to kill Ahsoka, he disagreed with and he did not follow his orders. So Filoni has been sort of, yes, loyal to Lucas in many ways, but in many ways he clearly has been against Lucas from the very beginning. He just didn't agree with how Lucas wanted to take things. So if you didn't like Kathleen Kennedy and the direction she took Star Wars, this is definitely a course correction in trying to move it back towards the Lucas vision. However, it's not really the Lucas vision per se. It's just closer to George and further away from Kathleen Kennedy. But if you want him to follow, strictly speaking, George's sequel trilogy and what he planned, that's not going to happen. That never happened in the first place. And The Mandalorian, which he's been in charge of with Jon Favreau, kind of reflects that. It's kind of a compromise between people who like the sequels and people who like the prequels. It has elements of both sides and has references to both. And more recently, it has been reference heavy towards the sequels, but that just could be the story. So overall, this doesn't change very much. I think probably the only thing that really will change is the prequel side. If you are a big prequel fan, there have been a lot of prequel references in The Last Jedi, in The Mandalorian, and Rogue One. But overall, the prequels were really not utilized during the Kathleen Kennedy era. They weren't forgotten, but they just weren't utilized very much. Again, within terms of the films and the main saga. That is probably going to change. Good or bad, we're going to get a lot more of Ahsoka, a lot more of Thrawn, and a lot more of the expanded universe. And while Kathleen Kennedy officially made a lot of the expanded universe not canonical, I don't think Filoni has to change that decision. He's just going to draw more and more of the EU into the main universe. And good or bad, that's what's going to happen. Now, I myself am very mixed on the EU. I think some of it's high quality, but some of it is not very good. This makes me nervous about what they're going to start including in the main saga, but good or bad, that's probably going to be happening. It's going to happen very soon. But in terms of the general direction or tone of Disney and Disney Star Wars overall, this doesn't change very much because Filoni has been on record. He likes Rian Johnson. He's a friend of Rian Johnson. So he's not going to radically retcon the sequel trilogy. He may de-emphasize it, but that may be because he wants to pursue his own stories, right? He's a big Ahsoka fan, and he wants to do those kinds of stories. But I don't see any indication he's going to do anything radical to reverse the direction of the last few years. But he is probably going to just bring the prequels more into prominence and try to balance out that along with the influence of the sequels. So if you are a prequel fan, that's probably the biggest takeaway, is that those are going to be referenced a lot more heavily in characters that were not utilized as much. We're probably going to get more backstory on those characters. And some of the fan favorites like Mace Windu or Jango or others are probably going to start appearing much more, whether through voice roles, whether as live actors. And they're already starting down this road with the Kenobi miniseries, right? Because they've made explicit that Anakin is going to return at least for a cameo role, if not much more. Basically, this is just affirming trends that were already started, that they want a sort of a more balanced diet. If you want more of the prequels and more of the OT, they're going to do a lot more of that. And the sequels may be de-emphasized, but they're not going to be rendered non-canonical. So it's unclear how this is going to be taken by the more extreme sides of the issue. As far as I know, he's not very partisan about Reylo, so if you are a Reylo fan, he's probably not going to do too much on that. So there you go. But on the other side of the table, people want the sequel trilogy to be completely erased and have nothing to do with the main Star Wars. That's probably not going to happen either. So he seems like a consensus choice. He's going to do something for each part of the fandom. But the prequel fandom should probably be the most happy out of all this. Now, whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, in the long run, we shall have to wait and see. And I myself do like a lot of what the prequels did, but I'm very critical of them as well. So it'll be interesting going forward how the fandom is going to react, because this is allegedly what at least a small part of it did want. They wanted intensely somewhat of a return to the prequel era and George Lucas's version of the prequel era, as polarizing as that was. And Dave Filoni, it does like a lot of what George did with the prequels and has defended them at various points. So if you are a prequel fan, you are going to get a lot more of that era. Whether that ultimately that's going to help the whole fandom, we're going to have to wait and see. But it's not, I think, going to be a major change in terms of the next couple years. But over the next decade, yes, I think we're going to see a very marked shift much more towards the prequels. Whether that's good for Star Wars, we're going to have to wait and see. Thanks for listening.